Hey guys, so welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel if you've watched my videos before. My name is Ashley Quintana if you haven't. My first video really sucked and my clickbait video was awesome. You have to admit if you watched it and you were like, oh, this is clickbait. But if you didn't like that clickbait video, like, you were just corny. But anyway, I actually got a request. I took all my makeup off just to do this. It's like midnight. I actually got a request to do a side-by-side of the Loreal Voluminous Superstar Xfiber, and I always have to get mine in waterproof because anything else makes my eyes water, like anything. It's not the formula, it's not an allergic reaction, it's not the mascara, it doesn't matter what. I literally tried over 50 mascaras, and these two were, well, this one, a side-by-side of this one, and the Maybelline Total Temptation. So, and again, that's in waterproof. And my holy grail before these was the falsies. And somebody mentioned to me about one in a red and white tube. I don't know where they live or where they got theirs from, but this is the one I used forever. That was my, like, holy grail. It's the Maybelline. It just says the falsies. Volume with no E, express, my waterproof, so maybe that's why mine's like has that metallic, like light blue aqua colored writing. I don't know, but this has not been used since I got this, and then this has been used once since I got this, and that's only because I didn't have enough time to do two steps. I had one two-step mascara before, which was, I can't remember. It was something like, it was supposed to add like tubes. I want to say it had something with the name tubes in it, but it was a red and white. It was a red and white tube mascara. And step one was white. It was like putting on white mascara, not clear, white. And then step two was black. And it was supposed to add, like, these fake little, it was supposed to be, like, wearing fake lashes. But I hated it, and I never liked anything that takes more time than it already does. So I don't like two-step anything, pretty much. But when I love Tati on YouTube, I follow her. I'm not gonna lie, at first, I don't know why I couldn't stand her. I know she'll probably never even watch this. Like, Tati, I love you so much. Like, you give me life. And I remember the other girl's name that cracked me up hysterically. Like, it takes a lot to make me laugh. And she was literally having me, like, my sides were hurting at, like, 7 a.m. when I was watching her on my back porch. Her name on YouTube is, I don't want to butcher it, I think it's Raw Beauty Christie, RawBeautyKristi. I'm almost positive that's it. If it's not, I'll like pop it up here somewhere in the video, but I'm almost positive that's definitely her channel. I love her. She deserves way more subscribers. She's hilarious. Like, I would love her to sub back to me, but a lot of people don't, because I have one video, besides for my clickbait video, which isn't me, I have one video, and honestly, it sucked. Like, it was my first video. Now I have a tripod, so I'm kind of feeling like a little more like, ooh, fancy, and like, I got a light. Like, I'm ordering more stuff as we're going. Like, I am saving up for some more stuff, and I got tons of new products, but we're not gonna get into all that. We're gonna make this a sweet short video, because one of the reasons why I haven't put a video out in so long is because I searched in the bar of YouTube, like, get ready with me, and there's literally a girl who does hers in under 5 minutes. Then there's like, there's never anything over like 40 minutes. I can't get mine under like 68 or 74, 110. Like, nobody wants to sit and watch a movie. So I just feel like, how do you do a full face of makeup beginning with like priming? You know what I mean? Like, I know they use editing apps and stuff, which right now I don't have a laptop. Like, so I just use whatever little link comes down here. Like, I forget what it's called. Direct something. Like, I don't know. I think it works pretty good, but it's really hard to edit it. Like, it's just, I just hit my lips. You probably saw it and I looked like an idiot, but so we will do this because it was requested. And I'm like, I know, I'm like so corny. Like, I'm super hyped that somebody was like, you should do a side-by-side of the new Xfiber and the new L'Oreal Temptations. We want to see. So I'm going to be fair because I don't curl my lashes like barely ever. So I'm going to curl my lashes. Or I'm not going to curl my lashes. I don't think I'm really going to, like, do anything. Like, I washed my face and I moisturized and stuff and I did my under eye cream. But I don't think I'm really going to do anything because, like, I feel like that'll kind of take away from the lash, just the lash itself. Like, I might do, like, an eyeshadow base on my eyelids just to make them evened out and, like, you know, the lashes stand up better against the background of what they're on. But look, I have so many packages, you guys. I wanted to wait to open them with you, but I just couldn't. I don't have my eyebrows done because, like I said, no matter what I buy, I got the, oh, that's other stuff. That's like, I got like tons of, well, not tons, I got three colors of the Revlon Color Stay lip liners. I got Raisin, Nude, and I think Mauve. I got, yeah, Raisin, Nude, and Mauve. And then I got these, which I thought somebody recommended to me, but apparently they didn't. They said some other thing. But it's the Maybelline Brow Precise by Eye Studio Shaping Pencil in Deep Brown. And then it looks like this, like, and then it has the spoolie. And then I also got Auburn, which I did that because if you watched my first video, yes, I dyed my hair. We'll let it down at the end of the video. But, because, you know, when my hair's back, that means the makeup's coming. But, I thought if I kind of mixed these, I'd get, like, a look to go with my hair. But, no, I don't know really what to do. My eyebrows are already dark. And the Auburn, I'll swatch it for you guys. It's definitely more made for like natural redheads, just like those people who are born with like that strawberry blondish, like red hair. It's not for like, you know, like chocolate cherry type looking hair. So we'll just swatch that, and that is what it looks like. So that's not going to work at all for me. At all, obviously. So, no. Don't know what to do with it now. I like the spoolie. And then the dark brown is just very dark brown, which I mean does work for me, but at the same time, like I said, like it's like it doesn't, I just don't feel like it draws like hairlines. Like I don't know, like I don't like my eyebrows to look like they were filled in like by a mini Sharpie, and that's kind of what I feel like this does. Especially because, like, my eyebrows are very sparse. Like, they say you're supposed to take, like, a pen or whatever and go like this, and that's where your eyebrows should start. And see, I do have hairs that grow here, but they're very sparse. And they need to be, like, shaped. Like, I don't know. I just, well, we'll do a little. We'll do a little. I know, I'm so corny. I really am. I'm so corny. Alright. Just to make, like, the look better. Because if you're going to leave the house with three things, I say leave the house with lipstick, a good mascara, and eyebrows. Those would be my top three. I'm not gonna worry too much about this part. I don't know. At this point, I don't really care. Because I was playing around with it, and now I really need to sharpen it. See how dull it is? Yeah, so we're not gonna go too crazy, because we can't. I mean, my sharpener is somewhere, but I don't want to make the video longer by trying to find it, you guys. So this will just kind of have to do. Look, it's like, choop. Chunked out. I don't know if you guys can hear my baby talking in the background. She is such a doll. I took her on a walk today. And it's so funny. Like, she's like the star of the show wherever we go. Like, I think it's just hilarious how much people are like, she is so adorable. She looks like a little baby doll. Oh. If you watch my clickbait video, you'll get to see her. And in clickbait, I mean, I think I named it like best and worst drugstore products 2017 or 18 or best drugstore products or worst drugstore products. I don't know. It shouldn't be hard to find. I only have two videos. The first one sucked so bad. Yeah, you can hear her talking. She's out there with daddy. She's chatterboxing away. She turned 7 months on the 16th, guys. They grow so fast. Seriously, like, I hate when people tell you that and they're like, enjoy them. You're like, I will. But you genuinely will, like, but people are like, enjoy them, like, as if, like, you're not gonna enjoy your kids. But, like, then you're just like, where did the time go? Like, please, just go back to that baby talk. Like, next thing you know, they're catching attitudes and telling you what time they'll be home. Right? I have a 9-year-old son, too, who's about to be 10 in May. Alright, so, of course, you already know what I'm gonna go in with. I'm not even gonna do, like, should I do a little bit of concealer just to kind of even everything out? No, because that's just gonna mess up my, no, not doing it. I'm not gonna explain why. I'm just not. Now, I talk about these in my first video. There's three of them. I'm missing the nude. I gave it to a friend, but it's okay, I'll get it back. And plus, the blush edition and the nude edition, the blush edition and the nude edition had a lot of the same colors. There was maybe, like, they give you 12, and there was maybe, like, 4 or 5 that were different, but it's whatever. I love these palettes so much. They're the Rimmel Magnifies Blush Edition, and then the Rimmel Magnifies Color Edition. That's what the color edition looks like. They're so beautiful. I probably show you them in, like, every video. Because I am obsessed with them. Obsessed. But to base my eyelid, I always take this color in the blush edition. The fourth one in. Because it's just, like, a very, like, I don't know if you guys can see. Let's turn the light a little. It's just like a very, like, neutral, like, see, these are all shimmery. That's shimmer. Don't get me wrong, they're beautiful, but they're not matte. So, actually, in this palette, that's the only matte one. So that's usually what I take to go in with on my eyelid. So let's do that. Just get right to it. And I have my mirror because, you know, the camera lights. Oh, we already had some fallout, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, this looks a lot different without, like, eye primer on and stuff. It looks a lot whiter. I tell you that. I feel different. Ooh, because I've recorded literally, like, seriously, no joke. Let's bring a little light back. Like, seriously, no joke, like, 5 get ready with me videos. Like, seriously. And then sat there and took at least, if not, at least a week to edit every single one of them. And they ended up just being too long, or I just ended up being like, you know what, I'm going with a different look. There's no way for me to remedy this and shorten it. Like, people aren't going to watch this. Like, I don't know. It was, but when I got this request, I'm like, that's easy. Like, yeah, I'll do that right now. Like, and I got it on a request on someone else's channel. So I can't even, like, shout them out and be like, hey girl, like, I did your, well, yeah, I can go back because it'll be in my activity of when she commented to me. I can just go back and be like, if you want to pop over and, you know, sub while you're over there, I did a video of the two side by side. So I don't know why it doesn't look even in the camera. This one looks more white. This one looks like it has more. It's not as down far to my lash line. But it is. So it's fine. It's totally fine. I look like a hot mess. I'm sorry, you guys. I don't know. I feel like we should add a little color. Like, let's not just be so bland, right? Let's just not be so bland. I'm just adding a little shimmer. A little shimmer to the crease. Ooh, I put a little much on that one. Just going like into the crease and dragging it up a little bit. It's not like a get ready with me look, so it's not like I have to explain what I'm doing. Like, if you guys want to know what colors I used and stuff, just let me know in the comments and I'll link them in the description box. But I am using from the blush palette. And just to give it a little bit more definition, I'm not going to add a lot though, but I'm using a darker color. But I noticed that it's harder to see lashes when you have a dark eyeshadow on. But just to give it like that little, like a little bit of flavor and depth, we'll go ahead and add that in there. Feels so weird though, like without like anything now, like without primer, I'm so primer, like I just started using primer. Like, it just, everything feels so weird. Alright, we'll use a little bit more. And yes, I am a big finger fan. I am. I just feel like, especially when you're using pigmented, like shimmery, sparkly eyeshadows, they always look way better when you use your finger compared to any brush. It just picks up like the pigment more. I feel like you can build it more. I feel like you can really pack it in there with your finger, whereas opposed to a brush, it just swatch it on the back of your hand. It won't look the same. It'll look better with your finger. IMO anyway. But I love glitter and shimmer and sparkle and shine and everything glittery and shimmery and shiny. Now, I did get this because I heard so many people talking about it. Even though it's the L'Oreal Telescopic, even though it's not in waterproof because they don't have it apparently, or they stopped making it in waterproof. I don't know. But if I do find a really great, like, staple mascara that I love that's not waterproof, like, they rarely don't. I always wanted to try, I think, the Stiletto one, but I don't think they made it in waterproof, which I didn't think about this back then. But you could always use that and then just take, like, a good waterproof Formula One, like, aka my falsies, or now, like, this or this. And then just go one coat over with that, so it locks it in with that waterproof. You know what I mean? But, alright, so I guess let's just get into it. Oh, first, I definitely have to exfoliate my lips. Because they have, like, no color, and they're just looking insane. And everybody knows, well, if you watch my first video, you know that... Oh, please come back up. Please don't die. Please. Oh, thank you. I don't care that you don't... I don't care that the black case got stuck in there. This is so old. This is e.l.f. when they first came out with the lip exfoliator in clear. And I did go buy a new one, and I bought the mint one. But I tried... I haven't even opened the clear one yet. I tried the mint one. Now... In their defense, when I first tried it, I'm like, what the hell? Because it didn't feel anywhere near as exfoliating. It didn't feel anywhere near as, like, just, like, it just wasn't doing it for me. And I have really dry lips. Like, I definitely need a good, and this is, like, a great chunky, like, harsh but not too harsh, like, exfoliator, lip exfoliator for me. And it's affordable, so I'm like, yes. And I eat it off because it tastes so freaking good. But then it kind of just felt more like a little gritty, but nothing compared to this that they sold years ago when they first came out with products that everything was like a dollar. And yes, I eat it off. Don't worry, you can eat it off. You're like, it's okay to, or you could just take a damn cloth and wipe it off, whatever your personal preference is. But all right, so just let's go. First, we're gonna start with the left eye. Should I curl my lashes or shouldn't I, guys? Because I never do curl them. No. Let's just see, like, how everything does on its own. So when I take this out, it does have, like, the, you know, big fluffy wand. And it's pretty hard. It's not very flexible. I always wipe the excess, like, off the tip right here. Just because you don't want to bump the corner right here and ruin your entire eye look. Right now, I guess it wouldn't really matter, but just for the sake of the video. Now, when I go in with my mascaras, I always like to do, like, the little wiggle at the root and come up. I'm trying to, like, show you guys and have you guys in there while I could see what I'm doing, too. And I was just talking to my husband about this. Like, there's no way to put on mascara with your mouth closed. Like, I don't care what anybody says. There's just no way to do it. And if you figured out how and you've mastered it and it works for you, great. And I kind of want to know how you do it. I mean, I kind of don't care because I'm still going to do it how I do it. But it intrigues me. And I can say, like, the formula is very smooth. It grabs every lash. It separates them. There's no spidery effect. Like, although I do get a little nervous with such a long wand, like, going towards my front lashes, because I am always scared I'm going to hit, like, the bridge of my nose. But it's definitely adding a lot of length. Like, it's definitely bringing them up there. And that's only one coat. I usually do 2 to 3. That's of any mascara that I wear. Like, when I used to go out, I don't go out anymore. But when I used to go out and go clubbing, and when I was single, I used to go out and I always used to do 3 coats of mascara. At least. No, like 3 coats. Of the falsies. And by the end of the night, like, it would look like I had falsies. Like, false eyelashes on. People would be like, what eyelashes are you wearing? And I was like, mine. But I never kept it a secret of what I used. I hate when people do that. I think it's so stupid. Like, we as women, we should be, like, empowering each other. I don't understand why women hate on each other. Like, I don't understand. Like, I'll stare at a girl at a store or something because I think she has really nice color eyes. Or, like, I love her lipstick. Or I just love, absolutely love, like, her boots. Or I love her purse. And I almost want to ask her where she got, like, whatever it is. Or whatever. Or, like, I love her hair color or something. And I always notice girls are always, like, say they're with a guy or even another girlfriend. They'll be like, basically the, what the, she looking at? Like, how do you know that I wasn't, like, basically envying you? Because I was. But that just shows insecurity. See, I just hit the bridge of my nose right there. But that's okay, because we don't have, like, anything on. Now we got a little clump over here, but that's because it's hard to do the outside. I usually do the outside with the tip of the brush, which obviously is always going to leave clumps. Alright. So, now, you know what? I think just to be fair, and so we don't start... Oh, boy. I just did it again. I think just to be fair, and so we don't start getting, like, spidery or, like, weighed down, we're just going to do 1 coat of each mascara. So, that is the Maybelline Total Temptations Waterproof. And I don't know if you guys can see, but that, and these are my lashes before anything. They're pretty short. They have a little curve to them, like a little curve, but nothing serious. Like, and then that is them before or after the 1 coat of the Total Temptations Maybelline. The top and the bottom lashes. I know I have pretty dark under eye bags, so it's hard to focus on the lashes, but made them pretty long. Now, we're going in with Superstar. Now, step one. Oh, my back hurts. Now, step one is just like the mascara. Apparently the wand is very stiff and hard. Not something I specifically like in my mascaras. No, I'm just kidding. But, and it has like this type of shape. Like, I'll just put it up against it instead of being like, well, yeah, I'll just, whatever. It has like that type of shape, like skinny in the middle and then thicker And we're just going to do the same exact routine. And this formula, I can tell. I thought I was really going to hate this brush. Did I just get it all up there a little bit? Yeah. I thought I was going to hate this brush. I thought it was going to be like super stiff and hard, and I was going to poke myself in the eye, and like it was just going to be a disaster. But surprisingly, it is not. And I just got it up there. Now, good thing it's wiping away so easily, though. But this wand is definitely good for like grabbing these front lashes and the middle lashes. And I just got some up there. And oh my, like I just, what is going on? What is going on? I was trying to get like these little guys over here, and it was just like boop on your skin. All right. The formula is very like smooth, and I feel like it coats every lash. I don't feel like it pulls them apart as easy. As you can see, to be honest, I kind of feel like we're getting some clumpage, like some sticking together, which is very like actually surprising to me and kind of upsetting, because I never ever had that happen with this mascara, and this is like the only like the fourth or fifth time I've used it, and I've only had it for like a week or two, so it definitely shouldn't be doing that. It doesn't feel like it's dried out at all. Okay, there, we got them to fan out, so I'm gonna leave them like that. But as you can kind of still see, there's like two little gaps right here a little bit, like, but we're just gonna leave them. And I gotta cover you guys and the light, I'm sorry, to get my bottom lashes, or else I'll end up touching the skin. And like I said, I already have dark enough circles down there, so we don't need to darken it up anymore. I just need to make sure like they're all coated and separated and they're joined in with the party. So that is the first coat of the Loreal Voluminous Superstar Xfiber. That's the first coat. And the bottom lashes. And then the second one is supposed to be the fibers. So as you can see already, I kind of feel like honestly, I don't know, you guys. That's a hard one. I'm honestly still kind of feeling this one. And we didn't even do the fibers yet. Now, the fiber brush is different in shape. It doesn't have that like kind of infinity symbol type shape. It's just shaped like curved. And you can't see it. My camera won't pick it up. But it almost looks like there's little tiny cat hairs like all over. Like it looks like somebody dropped their mascara wand on the floor. And it got all like dusty and like hairy. But I wouldn't care. I said this in my other Get Ready With Me video. I'm going to post that when I'm done editing it. But I'll probably put this one out first because it's shorter. I wouldn't care if they dropped their brush on the floor 50 times. I'd still use it. I'd purposely drop the brush on the floor because it's that good. Like, I just can't believe myself tonight. Oh God, listen to my husband. He's talking to my daughter. Yeah, like she's gonna chill, sure. The minute you leave her alone, she screams. She can't be left alone for 1 second. Cover you up for a minute to do my bottom lashes. Add some fibers onto those bad boys. The only thing, now, neither flake by the end of the day. I have worn both throughout the entire day. Neither flake, like under the eye. The only thing I can say is the Xfiber, this one we're doing now, is a to get off. Like, even with oil-based mascara, like makeup remover, because I use it all the time. Guys, I have to stretch my back. There's no comparison to me. Like, are you kidding me? Like, I always say that. Are you kidding me? Like, look at that. Look at that. Now remember, this is the Total Temptations. Total Temptations, and then this is the Loreal Voluminous, wait, I gotta make sure I'm saying it right, the Loreal Voluminous Superstar Xfiber, the two-step, look at that eye, and then look at that eye. I don't know. Honestly, now that I'm kind of looking straight on at them, like, trying to move you guys to where while I'm looking straight, it'd be kind of like straight to you too. Even the way how far these go down, they look like baby doll, like the little baby doll eyelashes. Like, it's so much of a difference. Let's see if we take a little light off and kind of just do like natural lighting, a little natural lighting. Like, well, it's pretty dark now, but like, look at, Like, I'm trying to be fair, but guys, I don't know if there's... I don't know if there's a being fair in this. Like, I am at a loss right now. Like, my eyebrows look so funny. Oh. Like, just look at the... Oh, did I just mess it up? You know what? Here, I'll give my finger a little, like, push on it. To kind of curl them up. Do you know they say you can use a blow dryer on low heat? And kind of just go like this to your face after you put your mascara on to keep your lashes lifted. Like, because I never use an eyelash curler. I never use hair products. Or, well, I do use hair products, obviously. Shampoo, conditioner. But I meant to say I never use, like, heated. I don't blow dry. I used to all the time. I do dye my hair, but I don't blow dry or ever, like, straighten it. Let's bring the light back a little. Guys. It is a little hard. Like, these bottom lashes are definitely way longer. Like, they're way longer. Look at that. They're way longer. They're just way longer, fuller. Like, they're way longer. And I pretty much put the same amount of product on both eyes. And then just look at that. And look at that. Like, so again, if I was looking at you and I was like, hey, how are you today? How are you? Which I would have you more impressed? Like, which one would you be like, I gotta ask that girl what mascara she's using? Like, oh, my poor boobies. And her daddy's not out there with her. She's safe, don't worry. But she just needs... Alright, everybody. This is my baby that was screaming. She was not crying. She was screaming because nobody was in the room with her. This is how spoiled she is. And guess who got her that way? Come. That is my babies. Hi. Hi, mama. Say hi. Say hi, world. Say hi.
Say hi.
Is that funny? Who's that? Is that the prettiest girl in the world?
Say hi.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, that's not what we're here for. Bye. Bye, babies. All right. So, I asked my husband's opinion. He likes this one better. He said it looks more fuller. And he said the only reason this one does have more length, but he said it looks like it's because the product is chalked up and built up on it, like product. So that's why it looks like it has more length. But he said this just looks more natural, more featherier, more fuller. And he said there's not that huge of a length difference. So he likes this one better. And this is this one. So there's your side-by-side. You guys saw it all from every angle. And you guys saw me do everything. I didn't edit anything out. I didn't go back and redo second coats to anything. That was one coat of each. So, you tell me in the comments which one you think looks better. All right. Until next time, guys.